I'm here at the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana, California, talking to the trainers and fighters about some of the biggest fights coming up. Check it out. So,
hey, you know, Broner Escobedo?
Broner Escobedo.
I think Broner will blow him out.
You think he'll blow him out?
Yeah.
July 21st on HBO, Adrian Broner, The Problem against Vicente Escobedo right here from the desert. Who wins?
Honestly, in my opinion, I got 50-50 on that fight. I give Broner the edge in speed and power. But Escobedo can box. He could box pretty well. He put up a decent fight against Robert Guerrero. Even though Robert Guerrero shouldn't have slowed down on the gas pedal when he was fighting him, he knocked him down twice. If he hadn't slowed him down, he probably could have stopped him, but he didn't. Escobedo is a tough guy.
So what do you say? Who wins that one?
I pick Broner. I'm not impressed. Only time I start to become impressed with anybody, follow someone's career is once they start fighting truly legitimate opponents.
He wins this. What do you mean? Escobedo's not true and legitimate?
Not up to the par as the people that Broner are.
That's what they said about Josecito Lopez.
Hey, well, if Escobedo does it, then we'll be talking about it. But if he gets, you know, destroyed like I think it's going to happen, then again.
Okay. What about Gamboa against Broner?
That's the fight I want to see.
Is that the Pacquiao Mayweather of the future? Because Pacquiao Mayweather, nobody wants to see it
Pacquiao
anymore.
Pacquiao Mayweather of the future is going to be Sergio Martinez and Chavez Jr.
Really?
That's going to be a great fight. I can't wait.
I'm really looking forward to that fight.
I think Martinez will win.
I just hope it happens because every fight it seems like I really want to see something happens that prevents it from happening. You know what I mean?
So there's only one fight on that can't.
Come here, I can't
There's
hear you.
Klitschko versus Klitschko is the Pacquiao Mayweather.
Klitschko is the Pacquiao Mayweather.
That will never happen. That's like Pacquiao Mayweather happening.
I said that in a video a long time ago.
It's a tragedy to boxing. I mean, they talk about how much of a war they put in the ring during sparring. How nobody saw it, but Emmanuel Stewart let the world see it. Because they're not impressing nobody in the heavyweight division.
That would do more pay-per-view than any fight out there.
Klitschko?
Yeah. Klitschko.
But it's not going to happen.
It won't happen, but mythologically speaking, that fight would be the biggest fight of all time.
Does Adrian Broner beat Gamboa?
No, I don't think so. I think that Gamboa will knock him out and walk over, grab the comb that he used and slap across the face after the fight.
I think that'll be a good fight.
The thing is, the one thing I can't give Broner this is the fact that Gamboa does make a lot of mistakes, a lot of slip-ups, dropping hands and things of that nature. So he might be able to capitalize on that, but I really just don't see it happening to the point where he can take Gamboa out. So I still say Gamboa is winning that fight.
What a weight class is Mikey Garcia?
126. Same one.
It's postponed. I like to see Mikey Garcia.
Just keeps happening.
Johnny Gonzalez.
That'd be a good one. How about, who do you say, Brandon Rios against Broner?
Yeah, I like to see Brandon Rios against Broner.
You got to see how Broner looks at 135 before he goes up to 140.
Yeah.
You know, and we still have to see how Brandon is going to, oh, that's right, he's not fighting. Shit, damn.
He injured his elbow.
You see, how often we have to say that fights that we thought we were going to see end up happening.
Man, this has been such a bad year.
You know what fight I really wanted to see?
Start off like a good one, right?
And it's probably not going to happen. You know what fight I really wanted to see? Brandon Rios and Maidana. I really want to.
That's not going to happen because one's with Top Rank and one's with Golden Boy.
And they're both with Robert now.
Maidana, I saw him today. He looks great. He looks ripped. He looks ready to go. And he has 4 weeks left for his fight. But he's fighting a very tough guy, Keith Thurman. 17-0 with 16 knockouts.
You know who sucks? That heavyweight guy, Seth Mitchell.
Nah. Why do you say that?
He's fucking horrible.
No, he did pretty good in that fight. Yeah.
I disagree.
He keeps winning.
The thing I actually like about Mitchell is the fact that he seems like he's listening to his trainers and they're trying to teach him to box a little bit. You know what I mean? So I think that that's a good thing. I don't see him beating the Klitschko's, but I like what I'm seeing so far. And he's always enjoyable to watch.
He was supposed to fight Jonathan Banks, but that fight got canceled. What do you think about that? Him against Jonathan Banks.
It's just, again, I picked Seth, but that's the thing is like, there's so many fights, like I've just been saying, so many fights that we wanted to see that don't happen. You know what I mean? And it's like it's happened so much this year that it's really like put a bad vibe on the sport. There's a lot of fights everybody wanted to see, but they all fell through.
2012 has been an ugly year for boxing so far. There you have it, right here from Aldo's Bicep in Tarzana. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Lasik Back reporting.